Good morning. Today we're going to do a tutorial of this wolf and this crow. And I'm going to start by putting some black on the crow. So if you can see that, I'm just going to start painting over here. And I'm going to do some black around his neck area. Just also the colors that I'm going to use are white, orange, yellow, black, and brown. And that's all we need today. Just putting some black on the crow. So actually, we might need some blue. I've got some blue here. For the crow's lighter feathers. And you can hear some crows in the background there. So we'll just add some blue to these feathers here. And some white. And make the feathers lighter. Around... towards the back of the crow. And get some more black on our brush. And we'll do the feathers coming down towards his feet. I've pre-sketched this. And I didn't have a reference picture, I just sketched. The whole crow and the sleeping baby wolf. So I'm just gonna paint the top of the crow's head feathers now. Just make it a bit jagged, your lines, because the feathers aren't all even on top of his head. He's got some sticking up feathers and some feathers going down like that. And we're going to put some black on his beak here. And the beak is a bit grey. So I'll mix a grey. And I'll add it to his beak here. So make it like a gradient effect. Make the dark black on the bottom of his beak and then just continue the black up to the top of his beak too to add some emphasis on the beak. And we're going to add some feathers coming down like that. I don't know if you can see that properly. I might have to zoom in. Just give me a second while I zoom in. There we go. This is the crow's neck and face feathers. So I'm going to do some more black and just try to create a look of feathers. Just keep doing some of these sort of lines like this, and some straighter lines towards the head feathers. And I'm just using more black. I'm just using black the majority of the bird. And some gray around his face. And we're going to add some other more bluish feathers. But for now, we'll just do the black of the bird. And add some gray. Just to make him look feathery and bushy and just do some lines of feathers. All these feathers are coming off the bird. Like this, you're gonna be careful around the eye. And we're just gonna do some streaks like this and create some feathers, some bushy feathers like that. Get some blue and add it to the feathers to make them more darker and more prominent. Just gonna create what looks like a feathery bird, and
the next 30 minutes are ad free thanks to the following sponsor.
We'll add some. Make a dark gray and add it to the bird like that. And if we can, we'll steadily paint the beak.
Thanks for watching. Click here for more information.
Do some dark at the bottom of the beak, like that. And we're going to paint his eye. So we'll do some lines like that. I'm painting his eye in, so it looks like darker in the pupil area, and then we'll add some white, so we'll do some blobs of white on the eye like that. Make it stand out some more. And we'll paint around the eye. the back of the bird's feathers, all down here. Now the bird is very... His feathers down his back are very straight. So we'll keep it all straight around here. And if we can add some darker underneath the feathers, like the black under the feathers like this, create some shadow. And we'll make the body go downwards further in the drawing just to create more feathers. Make the bird look I just gotta work out my bird shape here, so feathers go downwards. I'm just doing some more lines like that. I think I like that. That looks good. I think I'll leave it like that. And I'm gonna do some white on the beak. Push it and blend it and make the beak a little wider. Leave a line underneath the bird's eye. And I will add some white on the back feathers like that. So we'll make bottom like that. I like a bit of black, so I'll just make it black and black. And the crow is watching over the baby puppy sleeping. So I'll just make him look furry. He's cute. Okay. Add some black to the nose of the wolf. I'm gonna add some of the brown and mix it with some yellow and make a warm brown. We'll add some more yellow to that, make it more browner. And we're gonna do the shadow underneath the sleeping wolf. And do the whole shadow under the whole of the wolf's head, like that. And I'm going to make it furry, so we're going to do some streaks like that. And I'm going to do some streaks on this side. And the eyes are the dark brown color too, so we'll do the eyes like that. The sleeping baby wolf. and mix a lighter brown. We'll do some of the fur at the top and get some water and do some more fur. I'll zoom into the wolf. As we do the fur on the top of the ear, and as white, and we'll do some of the lighter fur. Like, this wolf is a very light color because it's a baby, and we want to keep the fur all the same direction, going downwards. We're gonna go this way towards the left on this side, and then at the top we're gonna go towards north. So we'll do the fur going upwards, and we'll do this fur going towards the left. So we'll make him quite furry on his body just by doing these streaks, these lines, like this. And his fur is in streaks. It's not really curly, so I want to make it streaked. And I want to make it look like fur, obviously, which is very hard because you have to work out the direction of the fur and then keep your strokes going in that direction. And the baby wolf has some lighter colors near his eye. So while that dries, I'll do near his eye. Do some of the shorter fur. And do some streaks of fur on his face. I'm gonna use a lighter yellow. Make some of the lighter feathers. Oh, feathers. Fur. Wolf. Because he's a baby, he has more lighter colors. So we'll make him more light on his body. We're just using the same light yellow. Mm-hmm. just creating his body. And get some white and mix it with the brown. And make some streaks of the brown. So we're just waiting for that to dry. So we'll go over to this side and we'll do some of the fur on the side of his face like this. Make it all streaky. And we'll do some of the lines that come down from his eyes and around his eyebrow area. Now I'm going to switch to a bigger brush. I was using a small round. And with the bigger brush, we can do some more prominent wolf fur. You can make it make some because the fur is like just do the ear like that. Because the colors are meshing and mixing, I'm gonna have to wait till it dries before I do that. I'm just gonna add some fur to it, but I won't be able to do that. We've got some darker brown towards his nose. Some lighter feathers or fur on his nose. I could do the darker fur this way. Just do his ears in this brown color. Just do some brown on his paw like that. We can do the lines in the fur that the wolf has. He has some lines at the top there as well. Thank you. and some of the lines of white. Just keep in the direction of the fur. Just keep in the direction of the fur on his eye. And we'll make some of the fur going this way. Make him keep him like a baby, so we're gonna make him furry, like that. And he has more white fur this way, going this way, so we'll make it streaked. And then we'll add this gray color to his paw, like that. Now, we're gonna make the ear. And put some of that gray on his other ear, like that. And he has a more darker color going around like that. Just get some water on your brush. Keep that brown. Add some white. Make the fur around his eye, like that. Brown, even lighter than before, and we'll make the lighter color around his eye like that. And we'll get the smaller brush again, the small round, and we'll emphasize the eye. And you want people to know they're closed. So now we emphasized it, we can go around and make the fur more visible around his eyes like that. Paint in his ears. Paint his little paws, so we'll do some white. We'll make some paws, and then we want some pink. a little bit of yellow, and we'll make it some light on his paw like that. And we'll do some brown on the fur going up in streaks like that. And we'll do the streaks continuing towards his body up. Keep drawing them upwards. That will keep him looking furrier. And now that this is drier, I can do some of the more darker fur underneath his body like that. And on top of his body. Just add the darker color on his nose, like that. Just add some darker on his face there. And the fur goes downwards like this, so we're going to make him more furrier on his body, like further down like that. Make it darker to show the shadow. We'll add some darker in here, in this area, just bring the light up. Now he looks like he's sleeping. And he looks really cute. We'll do some dark on his paws like that. We'll show the dark areas of his paws. And we'll do some darker around toward his face. Add some more dark and a line like that, and a line like that, and a line like that. And then we make some white and we're just adding some shadow. And add some darker in that place there, and then we've got to make some darker in that area. We've been looking furry. Now you can choose to do a background if you want to, or you can just leave it like that. I think I'm just going to leave him. Go back to the bird and add some black to the feathers there. And the crow is looking out for the wolf, the baby wolf that's sleeping. Just add some more black. And emphasize some feathers on him. We'll just do the bird's wing. Just make it look like a wing just here. There's some streaks of blue. Because the bird has some streaks of blue to brighten the feathers at the back. So, and also on his head. We'll get some white and we'll mix it with the blue. We'll make a light ultramarine blue. And we'll do some on his head. And towards his feathers on his... You can switch brushes if you want to, but I like using this brush, so... And we'll get the blue, the darker blue, and we'll add some of them on his head like that. We'll get the black again. We'll just make it less visible. We just want a little bit of brightness on the feathers. In certain places. Just to bring it out. Add some of the dark to make like a shadow. And do some shadow underneath the wolf belly. Let's do it in the streaky pattern.
Today, you can too, because it's National Shower for Good Day with Thank You Body Wash. Today, Thank You commits 100% of profits to ending global poverty. Actually, Thank You commits 100% of profits to ending global poverty every day.
Okay.
So grab some attention-centered Thank You Body Wash from Coles or Woolies and change the world on National Shower for Good Day every day.
Change the world every day.
Search Shower for Good.
If you pay for it today, you should be able to use it today. That's why new members who join NIV Online with any combined hospital and extras cover can skip the 2 and 6 month wait that would have applied
on extras like dental, that blue.
Optical, and physio. Plus, join online by March 31, and you could also receive 1 month free.
With the lighter brush.
That's NIV.
I'm a smaller brush. NIV.com.au. And we'll get some white. And then we'll get some of a different color. I've got this color here. I've got this blue. It's called Cobalt Blue. And we're going to use that on the feathers of the crow. At the top of the head. And some of the feathers on the body of the crow. We just add this color to make the blue of the crow and make some lines like that. And we'll do some lines of white if we can. It needs drying, but we'll just add the color anyway and then let it dry after. Get some of that white. And we'll do gray. Some gray of the background. We'll do some gray of the puppy. We won't do too much. We'll just do a bit. We'll just do some of the darker what underneath the puppy. We'll get some water. Just make it of all the shadow. Thank you. put it some more water. More of that gray color. And I'm gonna add some of that gray. There, and I think we're going to leave it at that. And I think it's done. So the puppy. It's looking quite cute. He's looking quite furry. We could probably do some more of that black. Emphasis on the black of fur, the top there. I like the way the fur looks at the top. Is the wolf. So I'm going to add some more of the black. To the streaks. Get some more of the white to reduce some of those. Keep him very furry. Get some of the yellow, mix it with the white, get some of that light yellow again, and we'll do some of the fur at the top, because that color seems to look a lot like fur. Thank you. Put in some of the white. I want to do some of the white. The gray off. Cool. Get the little bit of furry. Do some more of his body going around like that. Getting pulled up. Do his little tail. Black of the shadow in the book. Get some of the light yellow. Do some of the cute little tail of them. Wolf. Get some of that white or the gray. And we'll do some more. Make it look like a little tail. The streaks. There we go. There's a fuzzy underneath near their beaks. There we go. That's the wolf, baby wolf, and the crow. Thanks for joining me. I'll just zoom out. There it is.